Hi friends, this is Gail, Fava of Four. Everybody wanted to see that jewelry haul, so I thought I should do some of it anyway, and I'll be doing all right with you because it's overwhelming. And I haven't felt that great. And the doctor called me and said he wants to talk to me about my blood work on Friday. So, and I know him pretty well. So usually he just sends it in the mail to me or whatever. I probably have sugar diabetes from eating all that ice cream I eat. Anyway, this may be long. So if anybody wants to fast forward or whatever. I just came from 7-Eleven. That's where I get half my meals. I got a chicken salad sandwich, grapes, and some baked Lays. And they're pretty good. My stomach hasn't felt that great. But look what they had there. I'm going to give it as a gift to somebody. Look. Now they're getting into this craft stuff. Pretty cool, huh? And look at this they had. I have a fascination with these little hangers. And so I've been looking at the different videos and fooling around making them. And I'll just show you my few practice things that I had come up with. I had that one, and that one, and that one. My heart got a little crooked here because I fooled around with it. And this one, really not hard. And on one of the videos, the lady shows you how to make the heart perfectly, like that big heart. You put it between, say you want it so big, you crisscross the wire, and then you just wrap it around here and around here. And it comes out perfect. I mean, if you want a big one, you do it with something bigger. I'd show you if I had any wire down here. But, yeah, it makes it perfect. Until I screw it up. And then they had these. I know a lot of times people have a hard time finding them in gold. And I like these big paper clips. I like to make magnets out of them. So,
plus I got my package out to Jean Rag. Hope she gets it on time. I did a video just so she would know I did it.
Because usually I don't like to do videos because, I don't know, ruins the surprise. Okay. Then you know how I am with directions? Well, I'm the same way with opening stuff. I told you that time I had the prescription and it was in a bottle that I couldn't get open. And I was just, you know, I have arthritis in my hands. And I couldn't get the stupid thing open. I mean, a kid would never be able to get it open, that's for sure. I was so mad I took my meat cleaver and I pounded it until it busted in half. And then I took it back up and showed him. And, you know, it's about pushing and doing all this stuff, but sometimes that just doesn't work or you don't have the strength. So today, I'm looking through this stuff to see what some of it was. And there was this. Okay. But I spent 20 minutes trying to figure out how to open it from here. I'm thinking you go like this and like this, or do you slide it? I mean, it just seemed like this would be the side that you would open it from. Until I thought maybe I should look on the other side. And it opened. Oh, I get so aggravated with myself. I absolutely hate opening things. And I even have one of those roller things, like for that plastic stuff, that cuts it. But then it only goes so far, and then I have to rip it open. Okay. One more thing I'm gonna do to see if I'm a millionaire. Except I don't know what I did with the button or coin I had. I have about two lottery tickets. I thought, okay, there's nothing else to do. Okay. And they're good numbers, because somebody told me that if you get a new roll and it's from 1 to 10, that it's usually one of them will be a winner. So, here we go. Reveal one vowel and win $100 instantly. Oh, of course, I'm sure I'll get a vowel. K, J, I guess those aren't vowels. Okay. I'm doing it with this bobbin. I think I did have a coin here a minute ago. That's how fast I lose things. Okay, 16, 19, 8, 30, 11, and 6. Aha, now we'll see if the rest fits. There's gotta be something in it. One of these things. I couldn't show you everything because we'd be here till next Tuesday. Okay. 2. Nope. 4. Nope. 17. Nope. 15, nope. I haven't been very lucky, but I haven't bought any much lately. 24, nope. Come on, Vanna. 23, nope. I gave a Wheel of Fortune a year or two ago to my pharmacist for Christmas. $10 or $20 one, I don't know. And he won $100. And then he ran up and bought one and he lost. 14, nope. Stupid card. 13, nope. 26, nope. Went up to 16 times. Well, I'd like to just win one. 1, nope. 29, nope. And see, this is card number 3, so it's a good chance that I could win on that one. 7. Nope. 12. Nope. 22. No. I'll double check it later, but okay, here's one more. 20 times the cash, up to $1 million. Yeah, sure. Okay. 19, 15, 8, and 12 are the winning numbers to match. I never buy those other ones because, really, I don't know how. I get confused and I have to ask everybody. Now, this is a number 1 out of a new pack, so this should be a good one. But sometimes those things they try to figure out don't work. 7, nope. 3, nope. 13, nope. I swear to God, I'm going to shoot myself. 6, nope. 23, nope. 17, new. 14, new. This is a $5 card. 25? No. There was the lady there bought a couple $2 ones. And I said, did you ever win? She said, well, it's the first time I bought them. 16? Nope. I said, well, when I won $100, my mother ran up to the store, but she only bought a $2 one. And I said, and then she threw it away because she didn't know what you were supposed to do. 34, 22. No. Or she was going to throw it away. And then I guess she asked somebody. And she won $100 on a $2 ticket. And that lady said, I know. That's why I stuck it in my purse. So I could take it home and read it. So I tried to explain it to her. I drive people crazy trying to help them. Okay. Let's get to some of this stuff. I don't think we're going to get to it all. Well, first, here's the big bag. It's just different O-rings. There's all kind of chains. Anybody who's getting packages from me or getting chains and leather and all kind of stuff. I think she was working on this. And then there's a lot of these things that she made with these rings. I've got a lot of them. And with the little tiny, I have to take these all apart. Some I put away. Little tiny, you know what I mean, shells. This is pretty cool. So some things like she had thrown in here. Okay, like she's got a lot of these kinds of things in here. And then this kind of looks like something. From a sci-fi movie or a. I guess it's, you know, a bracelet. I don't know what they call these things. There's another chain. So let me tell you, wouldn't be Jean because I already sent hers, but Jeanette. Scrapping happy old crafts. She'll be getting some beads. Look at this. These, they're called spacers. This is kind of cool. Well, okay, here's a bracelet. And then here's another chain. And this was kind of cool. I don't exactly know. I don't know if it's broke. She just didn't finish it. But this would be really nice to take apart for charms. That's why I like this stuff. This is like a lot of this stuff's done already. This is like a key holder. It says Prophet and XO. And lots of these things. I don't know what to do with that. And a lot of these. I should do it like this. Dark beads. get this cleavage out of the way. I'm too lazy to figure out what to do with it, so. There's a bracelet that's done. And here's one I thought my grandkids would like. Oh, I didn't tell you. One of the reasons I think my stomach is so screwed up. My son's in the hospital. And I may have mentioned it before, but I thought he had TB. And he might have, I don't know. They had so many antibiotics running through him and an epidural for 5-6 days. He had triple pneumonia, bronchitis, and what happened was, I guess, he said he didn't feel sick. He felt kind of weak. But over the last so many weeks, he's lost 40 pounds. You know, and I don't really see him much, you know, and you can't tell him anything, especially him. Another one of these. So, why was he in pain? Because he couldn't cough it up? I don't know what you do with this. I'll have to figure it out. So, the other day I was talking to him on the phone, the night before last, and he was just, I mean, and he's really good. I mean, he manages pain okay and stuff. But he, they were coming with this plunger thing. And I still don't know how that worked, but since the phlegm and the mucus wasn't coming up, they had to put this plunger on him, like, for 3 days, and I guess it was really painful. He's like, Mom, they're coming 3 minutes. Oh, it just makes you sick. I mean, I felt like I should be there with him, and his dad's sick, too. His dad's got really bad bronchitis. And his brother just had his knee done. So everybody, you know. And I don't know. I just can't do what I used to do. It just breaks my heart. See all these beads? I think you had enough of that. So, what happened was, to actually take him in there was, he fell outside, and he's got diabetes, not taking care of himself, and he fell, and his back hit some railroad ties by the house, their house, and but he said he still didn't really feel anything. And he had lost, couldn't find his key, and his dad wasn't home. I don't know. You know, stories get so screwed up. So we slept outside. I don't know where his car was. You know, I don't. And if you ask, he gets mad, so. Anyway, the next day, I guess, his sugar went up to 600. And I think he passed out. And then, of course, he had to go to the hospital. And they said they don't understand how he didn't feel this pain. Because his rib broke and somehow went around his lung next to his heart left lung, but that's how they found out he had a mass on his left lung. Now, whether that was what they thought was TB, I don't know. But we all had to wear masks and all that stuff. And he was so miserable. He didn't know I took a picture of him when he was sleeping. And it's like, it's so sad. He's 36. It's so sad when you can't do anything to help your kids. But I have a funny feeling maybe this... And he still smokes pretty much. So I have a funny feeling maybe this will bring him to some awakening about taking care of yourself. This was in there. And all these little... See, it says $6.24 on here. She spent $6.24 just on these little... Those little beads. You know, they're like little shells or... Lighter. So they had four different antibiotics going through him. They had epidural. He just couldn't move, couldn't get comfortable. They kept testing his sugar. There was another watch. And today he's saying every time they come in and give him insulin or whatever, they don't check his sugar first. So it's been going real low. And all day long he's telling me to bring him up all this junk food. And one day it's diet stuff I go get, and the next day it's sweets to bring his sugar up, you know. I don't know, but he is keeping track of everything. He's even videoing stuff. Because, basically, you know, they're not... they're taking care of him okay, but they're just not doing what they're supposed to be doing. And he knows what's supposed to be done. So his sugar went down to like 30. So last night at 10 o'clock, he's saying, oh, I could go for some... mint chocolate ice cream. And you know what? If I was a little younger, and I just haven't been through so much these last few years, that I don't have any, my get up and go, got up and went. I probably would have went and got it for him. But I tried to make myself feel better by saying, you know, I haven't seen him in a while, and if I would ask him to do something, like, he'd never come. Okay, then all these things to make stuff. I'm sure you recognize all that. Probably better than me. Oh, it's a bead of some kind. The wire things. This is that dark stuff. And I took him a quilt and another pillow. And so today, he's telling me what he wants. And I said, okay. And then he says, oh, you don't have to come till tomorrow because my friends are coming. Then a little bit later, he just texted me and said, can you bring me some, I think he said, I don't know if he said baked or not. Can you bring me some, I think, baked Lays and these kind of cookies and that? And it's like, I already made him diet pudding and Cool Whip. And I have this other stuff for him and some fruit and some Diet Coke. Now he's saying, oh, I need the regular stuff because my sugar is too low. I'm like, I can't do this. So we'll see. I complain, I don't see him. And then when I do, it's like, oh my God. Look at this she made. I guess this, Pauline said this is a fish from Hawaii. And she said, you know, they're always trying to protect them. But isn't that pretty? And then these purple beads. So she made stuff and left it in here. And then this, I don't know whether this is a belt. Probably wouldn't fit around me, but I don't think maybe she was done with it. I've never been into making jewelry that much, you know, other than dangle charms and that kind of thing. And then there's, this isn't even part of it, these gold, those little gold seed bead type things. There's two of them here. I'm sure there's more somewhere. Then the silver with the little round seed beads to go with them. Then these little wooden ones of different sizes. Can you see okay? And some springs and then these are really pretty. And these are, they have holes in them so you can make stick pins or whatever, but they're like mother of pearl, they look like, and they're greenish. Just down here. Aren't they pretty? And there's some somewhere else too, I saw. They're really pretty. I think she started to make a bracelet or necklace out of one of them. Then there's some different colored in here. Then this looks like a lemonade stand. Looks like lemons and limes. This is pretty. This is a necklace. Isn't that pretty? I wish there was some ankle bracelet. That's what I like. I guess I can make some now. I can make everybody one. Then there's this. Isn't this pretty? My sister would really like this. She likes all this natural stuff like this. Look. But I had just given her one from a haul that I liked, so in case she wants to trade. I try to tell myself if I like something to keep it, whether somebody else likes it or not. And I'm doing better. Then these earrings, which I guess are for something. And then just all these different beads and circles and whatever. I guess we went through each thing. I mean, there are some really different things. Like, look at, in that, I'll show you this other one. Like, there's some beads, like, for stick pins even, that I haven't seen before. Maybe you have, because I think these are older. Can you see that? It's a triangle. Looks like a heart. And there's a square one. And look how pretty this is. It's blue. It's not a button. Anyway, if you had the time to go through all this stuff, it's probably some really cool things. I should leave the stuff out that's made. All I do, I don't even get one mess cleaned up. I have another one.
So a lot of that was the dark
stuff. I showed you that. And I'm not even showing you the whole 9 yards. Okay, let's see. Now these are all some kind of charms. I guess that you use with, I mean, you can use it with anything, but bracelets and stuff. Here's those little doohickeys. And then this, I guess, is for a bracelet. Like this is one side and that's the other. Or a necklace and it hooks. Okay, here's some pretty charms with the little circle on it already. More of these. Hearts. Oh, what? I'm gonna have to look up what half this stuff is. But I guess it just slides on. It's pretty. And square. Ooh, I drop everything. Like the square red one. And this is pretty. Look at that. So it's not like I can't use them for dangle charms and stuff. Look at the bows. Now, I don't know if these are just older because she's had it for quite a while. She was a school teacher when she had this. Then she wasn't. Now she is again. But is there a second layer? I don't think so. There's a lot you can do with it. What's this? Once you figure out what it's for. So, that was the one I couldn't get open. Okay. Let's see. I don't know if I should be doing this at the table. All right, these are some more of those gold things. These, I'm not sure. I was able to use one of these because my feet weren't working right on the pincushion I made for Jean Reg. So I put one of these in the middle of the stick because it was kind of flat, and then put a doily over it. But it wasn't these particular ones, but I had. But it's got this on it, so I don't know. Here's some of these little white seed beads. These little silver thingies. There's green beads, blue beads, red beads. Long burnished gold beads. These are kind of cool. There's different things in here, but look at those beads. What are these? Oh, tiny little flatback, like diamond or, you know, crystals. Red beads, blue beads. There's these, whatever they're for. I don't know. These long ones. And then here's some. Oh, deep green. Those are pretty. So, heaven forbid I should drop any of those. Like, here's a star. And a dragonfly. Somebody likes dragonflies. I don't know. Is that Belinda? Oh. This looks more interesting. If we can get it open. Okay. She was very organized. They wouldn't look like this after I have them long. Now, they are these. Now, they're white. They look like mother of pearl. I'm not sure. There's square ones. Here's the big. Yeah, it does look like mother of pearl. This looks like for a necklace. Look at that. Donald Duck. And I don't know who this one is. Something. Then there's these. For some reason, I don't like these. I don't even know what they are. Oh, then there's some, like, glass fish, stars. Here's some beads, blue, red. Now look at this. These ducks. They all have holes in them. These blue ones, or turquoise. These wooden ones, dark and light. These are different color, beiges and browns. If you can see it, okay. That's pretty too. See, in here now there's just a bunch of little ones, big ones, some spacers. Looks like somebody's tooth. Clear one. These dark ones. These are black. And over here, just kind of a couple odd ones, but that's kind of cool. Yeah, all these look, I don't know if they, these look like mother of pearl. I don't know. This is kind of cool. It's gray. Oh, gray, and then it's got a like a pink inside. Probably should be showing this a different way, but maybe set them down here. But I don't think it's gonna help. So I got myself into a mess here, didn't I? With all this stuff? Okay, let's see. Let's this a bit. These are all like wooden beads, different colors, oranges, blue, teal, browns, light browns, a mixture. These tiny ones, brown. These. These blue ones are pretty. Aren't they? Oh, there's a whole bag of, like, pretty rocks. Here's some tiny, like, wooden seed beads. This orange is pretty, isn't it? I hope you can see. I don't know what else to do. Maybe. And these are just all different. Oh, look at that. Not a button either, it's a bead. Oh, maybe we'll just do this one box today. Oh gosh, I see bags down there. Okay, let's see. All right, here's pink. Can you see them? Pink and pearl color beads. Black and pink. Tiny blue seed beads. Different color seed beads. Different color of those longer seed beads. I've never used them. The round gold. These pretty teal. Purple. Light blue. Now here's some red and black. Look at these. These are really pretty. Black with the gold. Can you see that? On each side. And then there's some bigger ones. Look. I have a few of these. Then white, different size. And light peach, like stars. These blue. Tell me in your comment, because I won't do that many more, whether you're able to see it or not for the next time. Look at these pink, peach, orange, clear. This is pretty. And then here are some green. Oh, I thought they were hearts. Just small. I mean, you can make a ton of stick pins with these. Of course, my Gigunda ones I make, I don't know. I have to use a lot of them. Okay, here's this. Are these pretty? I'm not sure if they're... They have holes in them. I know these aren't cheap. Well, if not, I'll put them around my plants. But... I think I... Hard to see. There probably has to be a hole somewhere. I'll find it. Look at all these pretty colors. Ah, hearts. And I collect heart rocks and stuff, so even in Hawaii I collected the I collected different shapes and stuff there. Things that look like things, like there was a piece of coral that looked like an angel. one that looked like a dog. So I will keep that one out. I could spend all day walking around stones and rocks trying to find hearts. I'm a simple person. That's why I'm divorced. Okay. I'm not a traveler, really. I'm not real adventurous. I like just simple things. Oh, and she gave me, some tools. 3 different kinds, I think. Because I had just given somebody some of mine, so that was worked out well. Okay, can you see this? You have to let me know. This is that dark stuff again. Look at the hearts. Just all kind of. These little ones. And then this. I still haven't figured, well, that's a clasp. Pretty. I mean, I know, you know, a lot of us decide we're going to do a new project and we buy stuff and get carried away. But she really went over the limit. I think she bought everything in the store. I mean, how did she think she was ever going to do all this stuff? Let me see. Oh, these are good for stick pins. Like all their little containers. Here's those. Yeah, see? Can you see those? They're different. And the reason I won't do any more, too many more, because in case you can't see them, look, stars, the moon, the sun. Probably if I would have something dark down, it would work better. Butterflies. A couple different kinds. There's all these clasps and stuff. Half of them, I don't know how they work. Look. Well, these are those ones, I guess, that screw in to each other. Started from. I have a couple of these too, and it looked like it opened, but I wasn't really sure. And then it has this, so you could put it, something on it. But now I have more to figure out. And she gave me a couple extra containers, just
that she didn't use. Do you believe it? And here's the bag of these. You see them?
You know, I have a couple of these. I don't know if I bought them or what, but... Well, they're not exactly like this, they're the, these. Well, not like this, but anyway. The whole top of it has, like, the diamond look on top. This is okie doke. Let's see if you can see. Let me see. Just a bunch of little orange and green seed beads. Here's some little ones that are light blue with like a dark blue eye in it. It's a pretty bead. These are black. These are black. You see these? These are all like animal. Well, not all of them. Just got some things mixed in here, but these are black matte. So these must be like the animal portion of the whole thing. And then there's these. Obviously, you clip them, but I'm not sure. Let's see. Oh, kind of neat for clips, but I don't know. The heart, it's brown. This looks like a candy cane heart. Some more of those long thingamajiggers. Some pink or violet seed beads. Let's see, let me see here. Where am I? Trying to make sure you can see. There's some green. Here's some of these leaf type looking things. And here's some of these little blue ones. I like them. And then just... These are just plain white. And here's, let's see, can you see? These are like black and gray. And up here is all kind of neutral colors. And these. Oh, my goodness. And you realize this is only the first tub. I don't even know if I should have gotten them, but it just seemed like too good of a deal to pass up. Well, let me see if you can see that or not. I think you can. I think you can. There's these. Those are pretty. There's round ones. Silver. This looks like tiny, tiny. Look at that. It's like a tiny little thimble. I don't know if the light's working. It's not. Whatever. I'm doing this for nothing. Look at these. It's a little mixture here. Ooh, there's a Roman, I forget what you call them. It's a pretty bluish one. Okay, then there's these. These are pretty. I guess they're to hook the ends things on, but could always take that part off. Circle thing. Some more neutral and gold. You see these? These are of different shapes. This one, here's the heart. These are different silver ones. Kind of cool. I mean, most of these are really nice for stick pins. Here's the one. I mean, I should try to make a snipper roll out of this for June Angel Pews. Pretty bead. Oh, I don't know what all these are. I'm not actually a jewelry connoisseur. Okay, we'll do the last three and we'll be done here. Till another day. Okay. Okay, these must be all her dark. These are all blues. Can you see them all? Grayish blue. Blue, blue. See, tiny little beads. Seed beads. These are really pretty. These little blue, dark blue. She's got some in a little vial. There's some pretty beads. That light's probably, I don't know. Here's some nice shiny blue ones, some square, different color blue ones. More blue. These are pretty, all different colors. Before I show the next box, I should try to make a couple, see how they turn out. Some really tiny black seed beads, or maybe dark blue. These are pretty too. Oh, I think that's it for there. And this looks like, oh, it's all done. Dark blue and gold. I think. Dark blue, yeah. Pretty. I mean, it takes a long time to put all those beads on there. I'll keep this one out since it's done. So if anybody gets any necklaces in their happy mail, they'll know why. Oh, I didn't see this. And here's a bag of wooden beads. Darks, lights, mediums. Patience. push that in. Oh, there we go. I guess so that you don't drop them all. Oh, I made it. Can you see all those? Some light pale violet. What the heck is this? These are magnetic. Huh, you can make yourself a ring and wear it. This is in there. Here's some light pink and pearlized. Oh, these are pretty. Really pretty. Shiny pink. You know, I have a hard time, but these are, I think these are all glass. I'm almost positive. And most people that make nice jewelry use all glass beads. Here's some gray. I mean, I think all the beads we've seen are black. I mean, are glass. Pink. Oh, these are pretty. Look at that. Aren't those pretty? I don't know. Can you see? This light's probably doing more harm than good. I really like those. I wouldn't even mind making a small. These pink and white, clear. Try to hold them up for you. My fingers are going to be sore tomorrow. Oh. Okay. Here's some pink smaller ones. And look at these. These are pretty. And then here's green. Can you see these? The black and pink. And then little round and square. They're probably, I don't know, they're too big to be called seed beads, or... Okay, two to go. And now you'll know what to expect next time, whether you want to watch or not. Okay, here's some gold. Let me see. Other side. Gold. These kind of look Chinesey. Black and white. Look at these long ones. These look like little donuts. These are all different shades of violet. Here's some of these again. These are red, I think. I don't know what you do with those. These are pretty. More violets. These are a mixture of oranges and beige. And these are like, what, the, I was going to say amethyst color, but there's different kind of amethysts. Like gold. Okay, we have some letters. We have all kinds of light and dark blues. We have fuchsia. We have black, round, and those long ones. You see? These are different kinds of blues and clears. These are pretty. These are greens. And yeah, they are all glass. They're all different browns and different shapes and little ones, bigger ones. And these are all, I don't know if they're black or more like that amethyst, that brownish color. Must have been gonna do something to start this one because can you see it? I'm probably making it worse. Tell me in your comments. That would be pretty to put on a chain. It's all ready to go. I don't know. A lot of people make jewelry and I can see making earrings and stuff. I just don't know how much of this stuff could you sell? One more, and then I'm going to show you what the other one looks like. Let's see. Look at this. She gave me some satchels. These are all, look like these are all pretty, very, the nice big beads. We'll save that for another day. But I'm glad I'm going through this with you because I get to see what's in here too. These look like they're all, most of them, some kind of sea beads. Lordy. Lordy, lordy, Gail's past 40. Way past. How can I make these things? I can't even open the things to get out the pearls, or whatever they are. Okay. Can you see those? There's like a goldish yellow. There's some orange. These are pretty. I really like these glass ones with the other colors in them. These like has an orange stripe. These. Then there's, I guess this is the reddish set. These. I like these. But yes, they are all glass. And I know, I think some people asked me, when I asked them if they wanted any beads, they asked if they were glass. Well, I think I'm giving up with this one, but orange, red, it's a different kind of, these are like a sparkly orange, different colors, black seed beads, and then there's these are kind of pretty. I can't get that stupid thing open. Oh, there you go. And then these are really tiny. I don't even know how I get them on anything. But I didn't bring it down, but she gave me this really nice, it's like a square and the magnifier's there and you work underneath it. She gave me that too. So she was very generous. This thing gets stuck, I can tell. This orange here is pretty. But it's as close as you're going to get to it. I like these. So, let me know in your comments if you were able to see them. If I need to do something different with the light. Because I guess it would be a real pain to sit there and not be able to see anything. That's pretty. Oh, I thought that was a G. It's the sun and star. But this was $3. I don't know if she was selling it for $3 or. And then I like this watch. I wonder if it works. If I get one more watch. There's another bracelet too I had from something that had all Disney stuff. This is really cool. I don't know how you'd. I guess you could just, yeah, break one off. You could either make earrings or a tiny chunky charm. I used to just wear, you know, I have some good jewelry. And I would just wear the same thing every day. I never really wore costume jewelry. But then, you know, you get to wear your one things to match, and now that's all I wear. Oh, I stuck these in here. This looks like, see, you can see that pearlized color that she, like the green. Isn't that pretty? And then this bracelet was in there. Let's see. And this. And then I stuck all these things in here. She must have made a lot of those. Okay, and then these are the, look at these pretty stones. Where am I? Let's see where you can see it best. Maybe here. Look at this. Black and white. Gold and white. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Glass. And that's why I better send down before I break them. There's another one like the other one. I bet Dee Dee, the awakening angel, may be asleep, but when she sees this, she'll probably like these. She only likes glass too. Little snippety thing. I think most artists like glass. Oh, can I see? course I'll figure out some way. I mean, I can't ship one more package now or I'll shoot myself. I have two packages to send and I just left them because I'm like, I am going to make something today, this weekend, and I, you know, for the challenges, and I did. And now I just have to mail them. So I was very happy with myself, even though my house is a mess. I don't have a clean pair of underwear to wear. Because between the hospital and not feeling real well and all that kind of thing, the house goes last, right? At least that's my excuse. It's been my excuse for a long time. My sister was here from California. She lives in Redwood City, California. I think I told you her husband was sheriff in San Mateo County for a long time when Scott Peterson was screwing up. And now he's some kind of, like we have commissioners. It's kind of like that, but they call them, I don't know, supervisors or whatever. But anyway, she came herself. She was here for 5 days. Saw everybody and left. I didn't really get to see much of her. You know, when you don't feel well, it's like you just don't care about anything. Too much stress. He did say I have gastritis. The other day, because I never had such bad stomach heartburn and stuff my entire life. Not even when I was pregnant. It was terrible. Couldn't eat anything. I really like this for part of a Chunky Charm. You know, I can make the things for the challenges. I can't believe I did actually even 3 challenges. 2 of them are done. Because I usually don't do challenges. I don't know. It just makes me too anxious. Those deadlines and everything. And I'm not a good presentationer. You know, I kind of like throw it in the box and tie a bow on it. And everybody else's looks so pretty. And cards, I give up with them. I just do whatever. Can't be good at everything, right? And usually it looks nice, you know, but some people just have all this matching. Today, this lady on Jean's channel, all beautiful matching paper and envelope and even the things she sent it in. And I'm sitting there thinking, okay, well, if I can get my printer working, I could do that too, because it would be easy just to grab something and, you know, write on it. You know what I end up doing when I'm sending somebody something? I grab an envelope and I cut it up. But if I had something, it would be nice. And she had flowers on it and the addresses, and it was really I don't know. I have stuff everywhere. And I still never seem to get ahead. I make more of a mess. I can make the things okay. It's just figuring out. I go to find a bag or something and it doesn't fit. And then I'm trying to, you know, make it look nice. And not too bad until you watch them open it on your channel. Oh, I remember one of the first ones I did, I think, was for Margaret. And I don't think I really got I think first or second was for Margaret. And I don't think I had the gist of the whole thing. And of all people, you know, I mean, everything of hers is just so organized and so perfect. And I mean, I think I threw all this stuff in this box. Just goes to show you, for a starter, you don't know what you're doing, what you can do. And look back on it and at least say, well, I got a little better. Now I can, there are some people, actually, that I send lots of scraps and stuff to, or pieces of stuff, because a lot of times if I get something, I don't give a person all of it. I cut it in half or threes or whatever, if it doesn't matter, so everybody can have some. And, but the one friend, I just totally... I can't tell you how anxious I get when I have to do these boxes. Because you know, everybody says, oh, I give so much stuff. Because I walk around and I think, oh, I should give him some of this. Oh, I should give him some of that. Oh, I should do some of this. Oh, I should do some of that. And then I have to tell myself, why? They have stuff. You know, I just get really carried away. And, I have to make myself stop. Like chains. Like I have so many of them. So it's like, well, I'll send some chains. Well, who knows? Maybe they have a million chains. And if you ask somebody, they won't tell you, which irritates me. I wish people would just say, you know what? If you have this, I could use it. If not, that's fine. But tell me what you need or what you like. And you know, I probably have more than I'd use in a lifetime with all that thrifting I did. I try not to do it anymore, because you know, you see stuff and you just can't help yourself, especially when I see things that I know somebody else likes. Oh, I know who likes this, I know who likes that. But then you got to send it out, and oh my Lord. And every time I go to the post office, like this last time, a lot of you got that message. Does anybody know Jean's phone number? This goofy guy is trying to help people so that the line can go and he could lock up. And I said, is this customs paper said pounds or ounces for each item? I said, I never had to do that before. Do I have to tell you how many pounds or ounces each thing is? Yeah. And then he goes, well, they'll help you up there. And then I said, it says here, addressee's phone number. And like, I don't stop and think, well, I don't remember ever having to have that before, just mine. He said, yes. So then I'm in a panic. I'm going through my phone, and every single person I could think of, I cut and pasted, you know, and I, does anybody know Jean's phone? Does anybody know Jean's phone? So stupid. And then when I got up there, the girl said, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I'm like, oh my God. But I panicked because I only had 5 minutes and he was trying to rush everybody to get out of there. So anyway, I did get the one out to Jean. Jean, you should hopefully get it on time. She said there's a possibility you could get there. But that's why I did the VR, so you'll know. I'm not cheating. I'll never forget when I did my wedding dress one. Helen Race, she did the VR, but hers didn't come till like, I don't know, a week later. And it was so funny because she won the whole wedding dress. You just never know, I'll tell you. Anyway, I think you've had enough of me for a while. I told you everything I could think of. I'm going to go finish eating my chicken salad sandwich, my big dinner for the night. I don't go in like 7-Eleven that often. So I decided, okay, I'm going to get a one of those iced coffees or whatever. It's like going into Starbucks. You walk around and it's like, okay, which one's this? Which one's that? For me, anyway, trying to figure it all out. Starbucks is horrendous. That's why I don't really even go in there. It's like a trick. How fast can you say all this stuff? All I want is really coffee with some cream and sugar. And so after I had gotten my stuff, I decided I wanted this. So I went and got that, and there's a lady standing there, and I said, there's always something I can't find, like the lids or whatever. So I'm all done, and I'm like, so where's the napkins? It's like I walk around, and she's, oh, they must have moved them. They were on the other side by the whatever. And you feel like a dummy. You know, you can't even find where the napkins are. No matter what I look for, it's like I can't find it. And then I remember one time they have those cheeseburgers or whatever in that hot thing. And I had gotten one because I hadn't eaten. And I said, okay, and everything's in the bag? And he said, yeah. So I get home, there's no cheeseburger. So I went back another day, and the lady said, oh, I bet it was so-and-so. You're supposed to open it up and take it out yourself. Well, he didn't say anything to me about that, and I'm not a regular. You know, you have to be regular at these places to be quick. And he said he forgets to tell people that. And I says, yeah, I asked him. I said, I actually said, is the cheeseburger everything in the bag? He said, yeah. And I got home, and I was starving, and there was no cheeseburger. And I wasn't going back right then, so I didn't even, it was like a week later, and she just gave it to me. I said, oh, I didn't know you're supposed to take it. I mean, there's all these lessons you're supposed to know before you go into a friggin' corner store to get something. And you know me, I'm like, you know, I have to ask whoever's standing there. That's why I don't buy the other lottery tickets, because I can't figure the darn things out. You know, the scratch-offs I can figure out. My aunt in Ohio that's in the nursing home, the one, she loves the lottery ticket. So, you know, she says, oh, I want this, these numbers straight. I forget all the things. Straight, backwards, anyway, all these things. And then there's the ones where you pick all these, or you can let the machine pick. I don't know. It's just too much for me. I'm stressed enough. I don't need to do that. I need instant. I want to win instantly. So, anyway. Okay, I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching, and let me know if you want to see the rest. If you don't, I won't show them. And, you know, we'll get to the point where if you want some of this stuff, as long as you pay for the shipping, whatever, or whatever is right. But not at this exact moment until I get a little caught up and my son gets out of. Even the cat's mad at me because I ignore him. I mean, he jumped off the bed this morning like a bat out of hell. I mean, he literally like leapt off of there because I wasn't paying attention to him. Just what I need. An animal I have to pay attention to. Like I don't have enough things to pay attention to. Okay. Bye, guys. Love you.